the worst. I wanna love you, baby, but I know I'd only drive you crazy if I let my feelings show. But baby, I'm a heartbreaker, a heartbreaker. They say that I'm a piece of work.
Let me hear you say, oh.
I'm a piece of work.
Work.
Baby, don't get upset when you see my videos. I'm just doing my thing. Just like RK, I'm a bass player. That little time to get.
Now, let's speak with the red carpet. Let's have a chat. This is the one-on-one.
Okay.
People in Kwashiva State have been watching your movie, your music, and they know.
Okay.
Now, who is Olumintin? Just say one of the things about yourself.
Well, Olumintin is a very up straight person, you know, very principled. You know, in life, when you are principled, you are easily misunderstood.
Okay.
You know, but I've given everything I know to the music industry, and the music industry is paying me back. Like my boy Bondo Crazy would say, if you show music love,
wow. Say, listen, this is what I say, man. Love what you're doing. Someday, one day, it will love you back.
Back.
I love music. Music is loving
okay,
us back.
Now, what can you have with
Olumintin,
right?
Exactly. This is one of the members of the country world. You understand? Yeah. It's coming out with an album very soon. Yeah. You know, we're coming out with singles.
Okay,
we're working.
We never knew you are into grooming artists.
Yeah.
You have a music label.
Of course. Control. I mean, it's an obligation. I mean, I haven't been in the music industry for like, what, 13, 14 years. It's only an obligation for me to allow my legacy live on through the future of tomorrow.
Okay, now, how do you feel working with a star like Olumintin?
I feel great.
And actually making waves everywhere in Nigeria and outside Nigeria.
I feel great working with Mr. Olumintin. It's a good experience. I know. Yeah, I meet people every day out there, and they always talk about, oh, yo, with Olu, what's up? It's a good experience. So far, so good. Thank God. He's a great man, as you can see.
Thanks so much for coming on, Javi.
Yeah, is it? I'm beeping my.
I actually look forward to meeting you in another occasion.
Yes, you will.
If you try me, I'm going to give it to you double.
I know. Being a celebrity is not a job. It's not an occupation. You had better have something doing. You had better have a talent. And if you don't have the talent, get yourself
I've heard about one of the most popular, most talked about events here in Lagos State in Nigeria, the Hip Hop World Awards. Although I wasn't so fortunate to attend the Hip Hop World Awards, I couldn't give you the tip travel, the details of that event, but then it was spectacular. I mean, a lot of you confirmed it. I got so many calls from so many people like, why didn't you attend Hip Hop World Awards? I was like, it was difficult getting media accreditation, but the brain behind Hip Hop World Awards, the person who has been able to conceptualize everything is standing right. Am I not blessed? He is right beside me. Ayo Animashaun is who I'm talking about. I'm going to be having a one-on-one chat with him. So many things I feel you should know. He's going to be telling you so much. Keep the red carpet thing aside. We're going to be having an exclusive interview quickly. Hi.
Hello, how are you doing?
Nice to meet you.
Same here.
How do you do?
I'm fine, thank you.
You are Ayo Animashaun.
Yes, you're correct. That's my name.
Same here too. You're the brain behind the Hip Hop World Awards. One of Nigeria's biggest events.
Glory be to God.
Okay. Now, how do you feel speaking? You're here for the Hip Hop Awards.
I know the energy and the effort, you know, that you need to put in to put together an event like this. So anytime I see anybody put something together, I always say well done, because the terrain is tough, there's a lot of hard work, trust me, you know. So I also come most of the time when I attend events to just show my love and support, you know, and say, okay, pat on the back, you know, because really it's not easy.
Okay, now, Ayo Animashaun, I'd like to just about that courage. Could you tell us a bit about yourself? Who is Ayo Animashaun?
Oh, okay, I'm just like you guys out there.
Okay.
But like some of you two out there, I spend a lot of time with myself to plan, to conceptualize, and I work hard a lot. And I know for a fact that distractions are all over the place, but distractions don't come as distractions. They come as opportunities here and there. Because if you knew they were distractions, they would not be distracted. You know, so I just set a goal and I walk towards it with so much. I dream big dreams. You know, I dream big dreams. So, I started a long time ago with Hip Hop World magazine. You know, when I told myself when I was 17 that I would never take up a paid job after graduation, and I didn't. You know, but it was tough. You know, you have to, you have to stick to it. You know, once you make up your mind to do something, it will be tough. But I mean, I stuck to it, and here we are. Hip Hop World Awards started like in 2006. That was like 11 years after Hip Hop World magazine started.
Hip Hop World Award.
Yes, started in 2006. And it was born out of the need to create rich content and, you know, reinstate the pride in winning a locally organized award. Nigerians will go abroad and they will say, oh, Chanewa Award winner, Mobu Award winner, what about Hip Hop World Award winner? You know, so and also to reward urban contemporary music. A lot of people...
Urban contemporary music.
Yeah. Yeah. A lot of people mix it up. They don't know the difference between pop, R&B, reggae, dancehall, you know, high life and all that. So we just set the record straight and say, hey, this is the way it should be. And just reward people that are actually not about their bank balance, but about the hard work and creativity and talent, you know, to make good music and put it out there. You know, a lot of people are talented, they sing in their rooms. But some people come out there, go to the studio, record, put it on there, we enjoy the music, and they should be rewarded for making us happy, because can you imagine life without music? So that's why we're here, to just support the industry.
Okay, now, Mr. Ayo Animashaun, Hip Hop Awards, unlike every other awards, or every other awards, is something that has really received national and international acclaim, because I've heard so many people talk about Hip Hop Awards online. I mean, people from UK, people in New York, and so on. Now, if you're making comparison, Hip Hop Awards, yes, it's growing. We're doing our own Niger thing, but I think the standards are really, really similar to some of the awards I see in the United States and so on, as in outside Nigeria, outside Africa. How did you get your inspiration? I mean, how were you able to come up with all of this? But your award ceremony stood out.
Oh, well, I'll say glory be to God, but I'll also add quickly that we are far from it. We are not there yet. BET Awards was when? June 29th?
Yeah,
27th. And I was there. And we're far away. I've seen awards all over the world. I've seen in UK, I've seen in America, I've seen in South Africa, I've seen in other parts of Africa, and I know that we are not on the map yet. We have a lot of work to do. We are not doing badly. Well, I would say Hip Hop World Awards is not doing badly, even though I'm saying so myself. But the truth is to know that we are not there yet, and accept and admit that we are not there yet, so that we can begin to look at the areas that we've not covered and how to grow. We're not there yet. We have a long way to go.
Okay, but let me interrupt you. What do you think the way forward is? Because you actually, you would hardly hear a few organizers of award ceremonies saying we're not there, but you are realistic, and I like that. You just bring yourself. You just bring people and hear what you need. What is the way forward?
Okay, we are not there yet in terms of like in the technical area, production area too. We are not there yet. Like, in categorizing our own brand of music in Nigeria, rewarding talent, yes, but technically we are not sound. I'm sure you won't drive a made in Nigeria car, so we need a lot of these things that we even need to put the awards together, they are not in Nigeria. Some people have it, but I mean, it's not everywhere yet. And we don't even have enough. We need to begin to groom and train professionals to be able to put together, the kind of show that we can showcase all over the world. You know, some events, during the event, you watch it. And when you watch it again on TV, it will be a totally different event because of production, TV production. I attended a show, an award show, and during the show, I left. I wanted to see what it would look like on TV. I didn't believe what I saw on TV. It was better than being in the auditorium. You know, because they mastered production, you understand? So a lot of other things like that, a lot of things that we've not mastered, you know? So we need to continue to work hard.